Tim Atkins is a poet and editor of the long-standing internet journal All the Above, who's created translations of Horace and Petrarch, zapped those ancient texts into modernity with all of their wonder and desire intact. Lisa Jarno said, Tim Atkins does for translation what Gertrude Stein did for nouns. His writing developed in conversation with American poetry, and for me, it feels like a liberation of poetry from its slow academic death that awakens its capacity for playfulness. The result is a joyful, public, and intimate form. He cites amongst his influences Basquiat, Zorn, Lee Perry, and Kenneth Coke, as well as the band of contemporaries whose work he has generously helped to nurture as a friend and publisher, editor, and curator. He's written that, I want surprise, play, passion, and engagement with the quotidian, and I reject the idea that I am teaching anybody anything. I hope to write open, happy, clear, immediate, political, personal, complex, inclusive, serious, lasting poems that testify to both the pleasures and horrors of being an international utopian artist in an exciting, beautiful, hideous world. Please welcome Tim Atkins.
That sound, folks, that all right? Yeah, okay. Thank you for having me. It's a joy to be here. I'm going to read 9 poems. It's going to take 18 minutes, and you can time me if you like. I'm going to read 3 poems from this book published by Richard Parker's Crater Press. It's called Petrarch Collected Atkins. First poem is for my daughter, Kota. When I was alive, I would type like this, the 3 fingers of the right hand and the 2 of the left, or hold a pear thus, or take the skin off a cucumber with a device in the right hand, and the pleasure of the white flesh and transparent seeds in a kitchen, for example, forever cloudless. When I was dead, I was alive. It is a wind, because this is the fashion and the season is in me more than ever. And if heavier on the right hand spine side, from excessive dancing in an empty room, uncountable like clouds from above, and I have seen them here as a reporter, unremarked upon in human life, in the nose, in the eyes, ha! A dad hand held in the man. When I was alive, let it be said it is enough to be in love with a daughter light, of whom there is but one in this small poem, of which there was but one, and to hold it all going in this small room, and yet remarkable.